morning friends, welcome back. Yesterday we were talking about the singular and plural forms. What we were talking about? We were talking about singular and plural forms, and there are some rules where we change singular noun to the plural noun, correct? The first thing was what, or the first rule what was that? By adding s. What we do? We add s to the singular noun, and that singular noun we change to plural noun. Next rule which we studied yesterday was what? If the words are ending with O, if the words are ending with SH, if the words are ending with CH, if the words are ending with X, and if the words are ending with normal S, those words, what we have to do? To those words we have to add ES. To those words what we have to add? We have to add ES. Can you see here? Look. First rule it is given over here is plurals are formed, see here properly, plurals are formed by adding s to the singular, by adding what? S to the singular. So first example is what? Leg, leg has changed to legs. Hat, hat has changed to hats. Here are some pictures. Can you see a box and many boxes, a hat and many hats. Second rule which we studied is by adding ES to the singular form of nouns ending with O, S, SH, CH or X. So there are some examples. Potato, potatoes. Gas, gases. Brush, brushes. Bench, benches. Box, boxes. Glass, glasses. And however, it is told that next one, however, a few nouns that end in O form plural by adding S. Like examples are piano, pianos, kilo, kilos. Correct? Now here are some examples. Question number one. Some examples are there, but then before that, I would like to tell you some more rules, how to more rules of how to form plurals. So look here it is. Change the final Y of the singular noun into I. If the word is ending with Y, if the word ends with the letter Y in the ending, what we have to do? We have to remove that Y letter and we have to add I letter over there. What we have to do? Y letter we have to remove and we have to add I letter over there. And after adding I letter over there, we have to add ES. Front side, what we have to add? ES. So here examples are L, A, Y, we are going to change as R and we are going to add ES. The baby is there. D, A, B. Y we are going to change to I and we are going to add ES. Understood? So baby has changed to what? Baby has changed to babies. Body will change what? D-O-D. Y we are going to change to I. And then what will happen? We are going to add ES. So what this word is going to happen, or what this word we are going to make? One body, many bodies. Next examples which are given over here is add S if the final Y of the singular noun comes after a vowel. Now, if the singular noun, if the words are ending with Y, now examples are what? B-O-Y, boy. K-E-Y, key. R-A-Y, ray. S-T-O-R-E-Y, story. So, all words are ending with what? These all words are ending with Y. Ye sabhi shabd tashani end hota hai Y. Which letter? Y letter. And before Y letter, everywhere, what is there? Vowels are there. O, E, A, E. Everywhere, what is there? Everywhere you can see vowels. How many vowels are there? There are 5 vowels. Which are those? A, E, I, O, and U. We have studied in first standard class also, right? There are 5 vowels. Which letters are vowels? A, E, I, O, U. And then here it is called that the words which are ending with Y, last letter of the words is what? Y everywhere. And then what we have to do before that Y, if the letter is vowels, then what we have to do? We have to add normal S to those words. What we have to add? Normal S, only S. So then one boy will become what? Boys, B-O-Y-S, boys. One key, K-E-Y, key will change to what? K-E-Y-S, keys. So look here now. B-O-Y-S, boys.
K-E-Y-S, keys. R-A-Y-S, race. H-T-O-R-E-Y-S, storage. Can you see all answers? Correct. So here before Y, O is there, that is vowel. Before Y, E is there, that is vowel. Before Y, A is there, this is also vowel. And E is also vowel. So I told you these five vowels you have to keep in mind. If the word is ending with Y letter and before that Y letter, if you are using five vowels, those five vowels you have to find out. And if it is ending with vowels, then what we have to do? We have to add normal S. What we have to do? We have to add normal S. Now look here, there is a question in your book. We will complete that question, okay? Question number one. What is that? Write the plurals of the following. Question number one. Write the plurals of the following. Some words are given and what you have to do? You have to write down plurals of those words. Come on, see here, there is a question. Write the plurals of the following. First word is what? Girl. G-I-R-L. Girl. Second one is B-U-N-C-H. Bunch. Third one is B-U-F-F-A-L-O. Buffalo. Fourth one is what? Dress. Fifth one is cargo. And sixth one is bush. Now I will write down all those words on the board and what we are going to do? We are going to change singular noun to the plural noun. What we are going to do? We are going to change singular noun to plural noun. First one, girl. G-I-R-L, girl. Second word which is given over there is bunch. Third word which is given over there is buffalo. Fourth word which is given in the book is dress. Fifth one is cargo. And sixth word which is given in the book is bush. Now, the word girl. What is singular noun? Singular noun is girl. So now this in this word, F is also not there in the ending, Y is also not there, O is not there, SH is not there, CH is not there, X is not there. So what we are going to do over here? Simply we are going to add S to this word. What we are going to do? We are going to add S. So when we talk of singular noun, it is what singular noun? It is girl. And when it will turn to or when it will be formed as plural, what it will become? It will become girls. Normal S we have to add, okay? Second example which is given over here is B-U-N-C-H, bunch. Now just keep in mind, the last letters of this word has what? C-H. I have told you, the words which are ending with O, S-H, C-H, X and normal S. What we have to do is, we have to add E-S to those words. What we have to do? We have to add E-S. Can you see here?
Yesterday we have discussed about it. By adding ES to the singular form of nouns ending in O, S, SH, CH and X. What we have to do for those words? We have to add ES.
So what this bunch will become? Bunch will change to bunches. B-U-N-C-H-E-S, bunches. Now what is bunch? I have a bunch of flowers in my hand. Correct or not? For a bunch, what do you call it? Even you call for a bunch bouquet. Right? If I will say I have bunch of flowers or then I have bunch of fruits in my hand. Bunch means what? Many fruits together is called bunch. It is a collective noun. Correct? And then when we see last letters of this word, this word ends with CH letter. And wherever there is CH letter in the ending, we have to add ES. So one bunch, many bunches. Next example which is given over here is of buffalo. Now here word ends with O. Same again. O, C, H, S, H, S and X. So then what will be the plural form of buffalo? Buffalo will change to buffaloes. We have to add ES. Right? Next one is S. Now this word is also ending with what? It is ending with S letter. So what we have to do? The words which are ending with S letter, we have to add ES to this word. So brace is singular form. If you have to write down plural form of brace, it will change to braces. Correct? Next one is cargo. Now what is meaning of cargo? Cargo means goods which are loaded on the ship. It is called cargo. This is a new word which you are studying today, okay? In your English vocabulary notebook, you can write down. Cargo means goods. Normally goods, which goods are there? There are many goods which are transported from one place to another, correct or not? If we are exporting to other countries, it is called export, and if we are taking from other countries, it is called import. So cargo means what? Cargo means goods which are loaded and unloaded on the seaport. Okay? So cargo. Cargo word also ends with which letter? It ends with O letter. So what we have to do? We have to add ES to it. So it will change to which form? It will change to plural form. And what will be the plural form of cargo? It will be cargoes. Next one is bush. Bush word also ends with SH. So we have to add ES to the word bush. Correct? And one bush, many bushes. You will see this bush, you will see such type of bushes on grasslands. In Africa, if there are long grasslands, huge land is there, on that land you will see grasslands, and in grasslands there is a bush. Correct? In Marathi you call it zuruk. Bush means what? Zuruk. Small plants growing together is called bush, and if there is one bush, and if you want to say many trees growing together at different places, it is called bushes. In this way, we have completed our question number 1 of English grammar book. Okay? And remaining part of the lesson, question number 2, we will study in tomorrow's period. I think you have understood the words which are ending with O, S, H, S, C, H, X. For those words, what we have to do? We have to add ES. If the words are ending with Y, we have to replace Y with I. Replace manje kay? Y kadaycha ani I takaycha, right? We have to remove, example is lady, L-A-D-Y, lady. What we have to do? Y we have to remove. We have to write down instead of Y, I over there, and we have to add ES. These two rules we have studied today, and we have taken some examples also on the board. I think you have understood. Remaining part of the lesson we will study tomorrow. Okay? Thank you. Yeah.